Yes, and welcome back to the 94 Club for your daily dose of country music. Hey, look, this week we have another week of good music. We're listening to Home Free, Zach Bryan, Jason Isbell, Red Southall Band, Holly Williams, Orville Peck and Upchurch to take us into the weekend. So I hope you enjoy it just as much as I'm going to, I'm sure. But yeah, let's get it. One other thing before we do. One of you mentioned in the comments how to help with the algorithm, and that's by liking and commenting. So please, please, please hit that like button. I want to see how many likes we can get on these videos this week. Also, yeah, as always, if you like the video, please do give it a thumbs up. Hit that notification bell to stay up to date with all the latest videos, and hit that subscribe button. You will join the community right here, be part of the 94 Club. We would love to have you. Anyway, let's get it. Right, so this is Waiting on June by Holly Williams. I guess sit tight. This is going to be 7.5 minutes long. I've not heard Holly Williams before. I know she is the daughter of Hank Williams Jr. from what I've seen. So she has got music coursing through her veins. So I'm really excited to get into this anyway. 7.5 minutes. I'm not going to hang around too long. Let's get into it. I'll try not to pause it too much and we will do that deep dive into the lyrics right at the end. Cool, let's go.
This next one is called Waiting on June. I wrote this for my grandparents on my mom's side. You know, obviously the Williams family gets focused on and that side of the family, but I didn't know my grandparents and on my dad's side. So her parents really had a huge effect on me and helped raise me. They lived on a little farm in Louisiana. They were together for 56 years, went through a war and 4 babies, and I lost both of them before this new record. And this is their story from my papaw to my granny, called Waiting on June.
So this is a nice setup, right? But what I want to know is, like, she was saying she wasn't that close to her dad's parents, and obviously that's Hank Williams Sr., right? Is there a story there? Let me know if there is.
She was North Louisiana in the town of Marooch. I fell in love in a week or two. It didn't take long to love a girl like that. We were benedictine in the cotton fields, playing horseshoe with the colored kids. I tried to kiss her. She grabbed a baseball bat.
I know the other guy's going to come in playing the guitar in a second, but I feel like he's just in as awe of her voice as I am. Let's carry on.
I was waiting on Jim. I hope she comes to see me waiting on Jim. I can't take this feeling of waiting on Jim. I pray to God she'll love me one of these days. I hope I find my way waiting on Jim. In 42 to fight those boys and pay my dues. Her wallet picture kept my spirits high. Charlie boy died in my arms. He saw Jesus, I saw blood. It soaked her wallet picture that cold night. Well, I told my best friend Charlie I would kiss his girls goodbye. He made me promise I'd go home and make Miss June my wife. Shaking like a drunk old fool, I hopped off of that plane. And I ran home to ask her in the rain. Waiting on June. I hope that she says yes, I'm waiting on June. Her faded summer dress waiting on June. Her daddy shook my hand and she lit up the moment I pulled out that silver band waiting on June.
I'm assuming June is a name as well, and it's not the time of year that we're waiting for, not the month in the year even. I guess it's her name.
built our homestead on. Joel and Becky, then Donna, then Shelby. Our tiny house was a sanctuary, laughed to fill those rooms all day long. And we were waiting on Jim. She's putting on her makeup and waiting on Jim. She's trying to get her hair curled, waiting on June. Kids, listen to me. You walk on down to Sunday school, and I'll be there in 15, waiting on June. Well, the time flew by like the setting would. Yeah, the kids grew fast, and the farm did good. Every day at noon that silver bell would ring. We'd all say grace and dig on in. We always ate together in those days. Oh, one by one those kids went off and found in love their own. There's nothing like the joy I knew when they brought their babies home. We'd play all day in the cotton fields with the dogs I raised up and ride. And end in grandma's kitchen every night. Wait.
This song is so beautiful, so beautiful. And you can't see it, but I've got two pictures behind me that are kind of there for, kind of there for my grandparents. Like, they're little frames of them and their lives and them at different stages of their lives as well. And it's beautiful to see. Anyway, so much nostalgia is going on right now. I mean, I'm living her story, but I'm also reminiscing on my own, so.
Honey, don't burn the bacon, waiting on June. Our bellies are aching, waiting on June. She turns that fork so slow. We all had to sit there till the last bite was no more, waiting on Jim. We were slower than we used to be. The nursing home told June and me that we'd have separate rooms, side by side. Oh, what I'd give for one more night of sleeping with my wife. Since 45 I've touched her skin in the middle of the night. So I'm lying in this single bed until they cut those lights. That's when she'll sneak in and I'll be fine. I'm waiting on you. So we can kiss goodnight, I'm waiting on June. I'll hold her hand so tight, I'm waiting on June. I'll love her till I die. It's bittersweet when love grows old and you really miss your wife, waiting on June. But they buried me last Tuesday morn. The good Lord came, he took me home. I closed my eyes, I quickly went away. But the angels let me see her every day. Waiting on Jim. Our mansion is so grand, waiting on Jim. Footprints in the sand are waiting on June. That's the story of my life. Cause me and Jesus are standing here till she walks through that light, waiting on June. Hey, I'm still waiting on June. I'm always waiting on. There's no more waiting on June.
Well, who watching that video has just been on that roller coaster with me, and I guess if you've heard it before, then you will have. This will be an absolute roller coaster, like a re-ride of that roller coaster for you. But just what an unbelievable song that is, about love for another person. And I felt like I just lived through it. Again, I've spoke about it before, when you feel like you're watching a movie or reading a book or something, songs like this, they take you on a journey. I'm not going to read out every single lyric because she did it far better than I could, and we'll be here until tomorrow if I do that, because it's quite a long song. The journey that we go on throughout this song of being like, the first verse is painting a picture of who she is, and how special she obviously was, and how quickly it took her granddad to fall in love with her. And the chorus is how they're set up. It's like, I'm waiting on June. Like, I'm always waiting on her to like, it's always, almost always like me acting first or me falling first or something. And June makes every moment better. So we're always waiting for her to come in and brighten up the moment almost. So then the next verse, he went off into the army and kept her picture with him to keep him focused and keep him happy. He saw a lot of pain out there, but has just by having her picture made him feel good. And yeah, his friend called Charlie got shot and died in his arm, and he was just being really sweet about Charlie at that moment in time. And yeah, he said, "Go and make June your wife." So he's decided that, you know, there's so many reasons he's been put in this position, and it's all kind of leading back to her. And yeah, so then the next waiting on June is just sort of. The way that this song's set up is like each verse is like a little bit of like a intricate part of the story, and then the chorus is like bringing it full circle, and I just think it's absolutely so well written. You can't teach this kind of songwriting. And then so they got married and had their four children, and yeah, the tiny house was a sanctuary was a really nice line, and laughter filled those rooms all day long. So we just really focusing on the positives of the relationship and the life. And yeah, and then the kids start going to school, and then the kids are growing up and the farm's doing well. And they go and pick them up from school. And they've just got those nice, like, picturesque moments of them being a family, and just described so well using words. And then each of the kids went off, found partners, and then came back home with children. And then all of a sudden she's a grandma. But that she turns that fork so slow, is noticing that they're both slowing down. They're not quite the same fast-paced people they used to be. And yeah, sorry, we say it leading into that next verse, we're slower than we used to be. He ended up in the nursing home by the looks of it, and they couldn't share the same bed, so they've ended up in a nursing home because they obviously can't look after the house anymore. But that since 45, I've touched her skin in the middle of the night, so I'm laying in this single bed until they cut out the lights. That's when she'll sneak in and I'll be fine. And I didn't know whether, I was kind of thinking, well, is that him dreaming that they're together, or what's the situation there? But no, it actually sounds like she snuck out of her room to go and lay with him, which is absolutely beautiful. So it's quite difficult not to get emotional about when you're reading through this again. It's just such a beautiful song about a relationship, really. And then that last verse, well, they buried me last Tuesday morn. The good Lord came, he took me home. I closed my eyes and quickly went away, but the angels let me see her every day. Yeah, it's just fantastic. And it just provides that real warmth and comfort to a relationship. And yeah, the waiting on June right at the end is him and Jesus are waiting in them big pearly gates, waiting for them to be reunited again in heaven. So it's actually really beautiful. Really, really, really nice song, Holly. And I'm so thankful for you for sharing that with the world. I think it is absolutely brilliant. Let me know what other songs you guys want to see. I have slowed down a bit myself because I'm like thinking about all sorts right now. But yeah, if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Hit that notification bell to stay up to date with all the latest videos. And please hit that subscribe button. You will join the 94 Club. Be part of the community. We are over 3,100 subscribers. I cannot believe it. And I'm so excited about where this is going. And this wouldn't happen without every single one of you either. And I'm so, so aware of that. So thank you. I appreciate you all. Peace.